Cooking. Definitely cooking.
Absolutely cooking together. My husband and I do it all the time, and we dance every time, and that makes it worthwhile.
Cooking a meal just for two. I think a way to a woman's heart is through her stomach, probably.
Cooking for two, especially if he can recite the recipe in a foreign language, we would never make it to
time. My husband and I use doing the laundry as a code word for sneaking downstairs where there's nobody else to have a little quiet time together. So I would say in my relationship, doing the laundry is probably the most romantic.
Doing laundry are chores. I like to watch the biceps flex during the underwear folding.
I like a handwritten card, not just the kind you buy from the store, but you have to actually put the time into it to write what you feel about the person.
I think a romantic getaway with no electronics.
Lingerie, because it's a little bit of something for both of you. Practical things, because really, what does that tell them about what you think of them?
Also, don't give them those ugly candy hearts that are like chalk when you eat them. So just gross.
A vacuum or an iron. I would use it either one over his head.
A scale.
I think it's when he's pretending to listen to you and he's actually watching the game instead, and then later on he swears that you never told him that.
Men not going to the doctor. They turn into two-year-olds when they're sick, and they can have broken bones sticking through the skin and be all, "No, I'm fine, I'll slap duct tape on it." No, go to the doctor.
Long toenails. Really, guys, either do it yourself or just bite the bullet and get a pedicure.
Ask for direction, for God's sakes. Don't still rely on the GPS that obviously is out of date or not working. Just stop and ask for directions.
I think it really depends on where they are in the relationship. If he hasn't even talked to her yet, that might be a little too soon.
Absolutely. You know why it's okay? Because you're letting her know that you're thinking about her.
No. Just no. Oh, well, I take it back. Sexting's fine. Sending random pictures of anatomy, no. Don't do it.
Not with pictures. I think sexting with some carefully thought out words can be very sexy and totally acceptable, but I think that the peen should stay in the pants. And unless there's, you know, non-electronic interfacing going on.
Well, obviously all four would be nice, but I do think that personality is very important.
Personality, because you can lose everything else, but he'll never lose his wonderful personality.
I can't speak for all women, but I would definitely say personality.
Personality, money and power are fun, I guess, but personality isn't going to go to bed with you at night, unless the money does, in which case we're talking about a very different sort of relationship.
A close shave. You want those kisses to be extra smooth and close.
His breath, especially if he wants kisses.
Well, I think that a lot of guys, sorry guys, are thinking of going into a date with the idea that they might get lucky. So it's pretty sexy if a guy is prepared with a raincoat to suit up with. It's okay for a guy to admit that he cries because it shows that he is feeling emotion and he's able to connect with you emotionally.
I don't think so. Does that make me a bad person not being that sensitive in the 21st century here? But no, I don't think it's that attractive to admit crying.
I think it's attractive when a man admits he can cry, but I wouldn't want to watch a man cry.
I say go for it, who's ever ready.
Ooh, either one. Depends on the situation.
I'm 100% old-fashioned. I don't have the guts to make the first move on a guy, so I 100% think that the guy should make the first move.
Onions or garlic?
Ribs. Such a mess. Nobody can look attractive while eating them.
Beans. I mean, let's just go out and say it. Nobody should eat beans on a first date, especially if you don't think that the date is going to end at the end of dinner.
Are they planning on hanky-panky times? Because asparagus would be a bad idea.